Hello everyone, welcome to the Power Play with CJ. I'm going to focus in on the Ottawa Senators naming Guy Boucher, their new coach, and you know why I really like the move. Obviously, Bruce Boudreau was, you know, who they were going after. He was their hot to trot, you know, big name, plus he's an Ottawa native. But Guy Boucher, I mean, it wasn't too long ago, you know, he was the hottest name in hockey for, you know, when Tampa brought him in. And, you know, he helped out that Lightning team go to the Eastern Conference Finals in his first year behind the bench. And you know, I think he's in a similar situation in Ottawa with a lot of young talent, and you know, I think he can be, you know, a guy that helps this nucleus grow. And you know, I love the way he coaches. You know, he doesn't lump players together. You know, every player is treated individually, and you know, I think that speaks a lot about his background in psychology. So it's, you know, pretty cool there, and I really like that. You know, he's able to get, you know, the best out of the guys he has. Now the thing that kind of bit him in the ass in Tampa the last 2 years was the goaltending was atrocious. Ben Bishop was not on the team yet. They had, you know, 40-year-old Dwayne Rolison, who after a Cinderella run to the Eastern Conference Final kind of deteriorated. It was in Lindback for a while. Just that situation just wasn't what they thought it was going to be. So, you know, it's can't fault Boucher for that, and I think, you know, going over and coaching in Switzerland the last couple of years was a good thing for him. And he's got Mark Crawford, you know, as an associate head coach. So I think he'll do a fantastic job, you know, having that experience, having a guy like Crawford that's won a Stanley Cup and, you know, done a lot of things as that, you know, second voice, if you will. And, you know, we'll see how it all shakes itself up in the next few months going into the season. But I think he's going to do a fantastic job. I mean, there were a lot of head coaching vacancies in the last couple of years that I think he should have been given more consideration for. Now, I don't know the specifics with the Swiss contract and everything. But, you know, I think Montreal, letting him leave that organization was foolish. And I think they had the opportunity this year to bring him back. And, you know, I'm not faulting Michel Therrien entirely for the team's struggles this year, but I think with a different voice in that locker room, the Habs would be, you know, better off, but what do I know? Anyway, that's all I got. This episode of the Power Play with CJ. Stay tuned for episodes throughout the season and beyond. Later, guys.